So the second presentation this afternoon is myself. My name is Erin Cordes. I'm from South Dakota State University. But this project here that I want to share some information with really originated in the first Waste to Worth conference in 2013. At that meeting, we had a discussion about making nutrient management standards work where we work, looking at some of the regional differences, but then also looking at some of the organizational differences, particularly within the Natural Resource Conservation Service. But that spurred the idea of how can we understand a little bit better how different organizations share information, how do they use information, and who do different organizations work with? What are those partnerships? So we kind of started out by looking at what are some of the barriers to information transfer. Education and outreach portions of projects, several projects are integrated. Are they reaching the target audience? Needs of service agents, the people with the boots on the ground, as was mentioned this morning, maybe don't always get, their needs aren't necessarily always understood also by research projects, and then vice versa, right? How do we better adapt our tools? That's the big overarching goal that we started out with this project, which we called the Pathways Project. We formed a national working group. We had a presentation in the 2015 Waste to Worth conference, which was basically the startup of a lot of this. Through the years, we've had some different funding provided through the North Central Region Water Network, as well as the South Dakota SARE program. But really, the crux of this program has been the number of people across the country involved with contributing to developing this project, sharing the survey, and then looking at the results as well. Too many names to mention individually, but I do want to point out members of our North Central Region team, Nicole, Jill, Tang, Jeffrey Jaquette, Michelle Cassou, and Amy Schmidt. This group really pulled together to make the survey and help get it out. So I wanted to make sure that I mention their names. The Pathways Survey, like I mentioned, was a survey that we distributed nationally. It reached over 900 people. 600 of those people made it through to the end of the survey. Most of them answered at least a few of the questions. The way we disseminated the survey nationally was through our network, through the LPLC, sent it to some different commodity organizations, they sent it among their members, we sent it to some of the regulatory organizational bodies, and they sent it out through their members. So we used this snowball technique to reach the vast number of people that are in this manure management network. What we were trying to gauge is basically these types of questions. What is their level of knowledge and what's the importance that they place on manure management? What organization are they affiliated with? What are the tasks that they do on a regular basis that are related to manure nutrient management, natural resource concerns? And then we looked at, for the information that they use, what type of information do they use? Journal publications, conferences, where do they get information and what's the relevance of that information? What are the barriers to those information sources? We looked at the products that they produce. What products do you produce was the question in the survey, or what is the relevance of those products? What are the barriers to producing them? But really what we're going to get at today is this, what were the collaborations and the barriers to relationships within the network? So just as that overview, like I said, fairly large response rate. We were happy with the number of responses. Geographical distribution was pretty good. We reached 49 states and 4 provinces. And then 50% of our responses were from these 6 states. So Pennsylvania won. That we had same responses we got at the last meeting. They were leading and the 2015 Waste to Worth, we had just started disseminating the survey, and Pennsylvania was in the lead at the start of that meeting too. But we had a good response from South Dakota, Nebraska, North Dakota, Ohio, and Oklahoma as well. So we felt that we had a fairly good distribution of responses. As far as the organization types that responded, and this plays into some of the later results that I'm going to share today, major University Extension, government non-regulatory agencies. So government non-regulatory agencies would be like Natural Resource Conservation Service, government regulatory agencies, producers, and then others were news media, tribal governments, commodity organizations, several other organizations. So most of our results focus on these types of organizations. Like I said, it's going to play into the results that we see later on. As far as the people that replied, you know, most of us in this room and that responded to the survey, both are what our self-perceived level of knowledge is on this topic, as well as the importance that we place on this issue, both ended up tracking pretty good. Basically, as far as the network goes, we feel that we have some to a great deal of knowledge about manure nutrient management and that it's an important issue. You know, so we had a fairly consistent, it was interesting how well those two questions tracked. But what we got at, or what we were trying to get at, or what I'm trying to get at with this presentation, excuse me, is how important is collaboration with each of the following groups related to manure nutrient management. So this was basically our survey question, and we asked folks for the different organizations that they could work with related to manure nutrient management, how relevant, and we use that word relevant in the survey, were these types of collaborators. And on a scale of 1, not important, to 4, very important, this is how the average relevant scores came out. On the bottom, we have producers, and they were, on average, the highest relevant score. So if we took everybody's score of how they rated collaborations with producers, came out about 3.5. On the other end of that, with tribal governments or agencies, which was a very small population in our survey pool as well, should note, very still above 2, right? There was still some average on average importance, but it was on the lower end. And then within here, you can see a range of values. What we do see in this chart here is that at this bottom end, where we have the higher relevance scores, we have producers, university extension, state agency, federal agency, and then county or local agency. Now, by show of hands, is there anyone in this room not affiliated with one of those groups? And so these were the main groups that were also responding to the survey. Now, question is, did we just simply miss some other major populations within the manure nutrient management professional realm, right? Or is it just simply that there isn't as many of them and our survey captured that population? So that's, you know, that's always a question when you look at survey data, is how to interpret it. But what then I think this shows is that with producers, and these other 4, I would say, top ranked in terms of relevance manure groups, that there's a fairly consistent average relevance score as well. You know, I think what this conference and what this shows is that these groups are used to working together. We find relevance in what each other does. The second part to this question then was, what barriers, if any, deter you from collaboration with each of the following groups? Now, this question was posed as a select all that apply question. So for all the barriers that we provided in the survey, which barriers exist? This is an overall snapshot. I put it up because I think it's pretty, lots of colors. But the way to look at this, and I did put their average relevance scores on this column for you. But this light blue on the right is no barriers to use. And as you can see, for most of the organizations, the majority of responses for these different groups was no barriers to use, with the exception of maybe one group or a couple groups. No barriers to use. The purple might be a little difficult to read, is discouraged or not allowed. Generally not a lot of purple, right? The green, no incentive to collaborate. Red, do not have a relationship. And blue, not relevant to my job. Now, if we look a little bit closer at some of the specific organizations, I basically divided them between the 5 with the lower relevance score and the 6 with the higher relevance score. If we look at those first, with the higher relevance scores shows the majority of responses were no barriers to use. You know, I think that comes, applies back to that relevance question. There is some good working relationships already established within the federal agencies, state agencies, university extension, local agencies, and producers. Of the barriers that were mentioned, no incentive and just simple lack of relationship were there. I thought it was interesting that, you know, if just geographically, state agency geographically would be between a local and a federal agency, right? But there still seemed to be a slightly stronger relationship there. Again, might be partly due to the response or the survey population, but in general, no barriers to collaboration within this group. But if we look at the other groups that are part of this network that we all work in, what are the barriers? You know, there were a lot of people that indicated no barriers to those types of collaborations. But when we look at the other potential barriers, with tribal agencies not relevant to my job, so that does have some regional implications, or tribal agencies are have more prominence in different geographical areas. That can be part of it. Public service, private enterprises, private services, news media, they still had some barriers mentioned of not relevant, but they were generally lower. This red bar, or the proportion that was do not have a relationship, was pretty consistent, at least among the first four mentioned here. I think that's a gap where, if we feel that these are important relationships, I guess that's the first barrier that I would look at. How do we overcome that? Establishing relationships. You know, is it through conferences like this? Is it just simple phone calls? How do we get over that hump? I think it's going to be different geographically, going to be different with the different organizations, the different tribal organizations that you could potentially be working with. But it's just establishing that relationship. Simple, but I think this puts some numbers to that gap that we can look at overcoming. No incentive to collaborate was mentioned. And discouraged or not allowed was pretty minimal. The biggest indication of that would have been with news and media. And I think we can understand, especially with the field we work in, which can have some controversy to it, where that might fit in. So how can we use this information? I didn't dive necessarily very deep into the data or different relationships. There's a lot of different ways that we could potentially look at this, and if anyone else wants to analyze the data, more than welcome to do it. But how can we use this information? This is just a brainstorm list, and I'm open to other ideas, other suggestions. But I think when it talks about what are some barriers to collaboration as we look at integrated grants, as we look at grants that are about sharing information, maybe this information can provide us some justification when it comes to grants. You know, establishing relationships and finding relevancy among organizations are what we need to overcome if an intended audience is based on our intended audience. What we didn't look at in the survey is the levels of relationships. We asked it in the terms of collaboration, but you know, we can have networks where we just know people, we can reach out to people. We can have collaborations where we come together with a common goal, but then we can have partnerships, which are more formal relationships. You know, we didn't survey people on the levels of relationships that different organizations have, and I think that would provide an even more clearer picture, but of course be a more complicated survey to both administer and analyze, right? But, I mean, if that is a potential direction that we could look at is strengthening our knowledge of these links, let's say. In the end, our goal is effective and responsible manure nutrient management. That's what we're trying to promote. The goal of this Pathways project was, if we want to get a piece of information from one group to another, if we want to do a direct link, how do we do it? If we want to work through five other organizations to get to our end audience, how do we do it? This is just looking at those direct one-to-one relationships, but it can help in that pathway of information flow. Pathways project, we wrapped up for the most part, but we hope to share some more of the information regarding this over time. If you do have some information about the data that was collected, what we've learned from it so far, please feel free to ask myself, Nicole, if you want to wave your hand in the back there. The other is the other project lead, or any of the North Central Region partners as well, would be happy to help you. With that, any questions?